Welcome, students. In this course called Communicative Grammar 3, we are going to talk something about the present perfect and the present perfect progressive. The first thing that we are going to talk about is the use of since and for with the present perfect. You can use the present perfect to talk about things that happen at an indefinite time in the past. For example, they traveled to Manta. When you say they traveled to Manta, you don't know exactly when they traveled to Manta. Okay? Ustedes no saben exactamente cuándo se viajó a Manta. Por eso se llama indefinite time in the past. Simplemente ellos viajaron. Ellos han viajado a Manta, ¿no? Entonces no se sabe cuándo se viajó a Manta. They traveled to Manta. You don't know exactly when they traveled to Manta. Okay. Now, we use the present perfect with since or for to talk about something that began in the past and continues into the present and may continue into the future. For example, if we say Roberto has been rich since 2005. Okay. Estamos diciendo Roberto ha sido rico desde el 2005. Es decir, una acción que empezó en el 2005, continúa en el presente y podría continuar en el futuro. Okay. En este caso estamos utilizando since para referirnos que la acción empezó en el 2005. Okay. So in this case, the action of being rich started in 2005. Okay, so the use is the following. We use since plus point in time to show when something started. In the first example, I have played chess since I was a child. Okay, it means that in this case, the action started when the person was a child. Okay, and continues to the present and may continue into the future. Okay. The use of for. Okay, when we use for with the present perfect, we use for plus the length of time to show how long something has lasted. Okay. In the example, Joe has sold computers for a long time. Joe ha vendido computadores por un largo tiempo. It means the period of time. Okay. Entonces es for más el periodo de tiempo para indicar cuánto ha durado la acción. For a long time in this case, por un largo tiempo. Okay, now we are going to see the difference between using the present perfect progressive and the present perfect. Okay, we often use the present perfect to talk about how much someone has done, how many things someone has done, or how many times someone has done something. Okay, so we have the three examples of it. In the first example, I've learned a lot about it. Okay, in this case, I'm talking about how much someone has done. Okay, he aprendido mucho sobre esto, ¿no? Cuánto, en este caso, cuánto ha aprendido la persona. In the second example, he's written 3 articles. Okay, in this case, how many things someone has done. Okay, how many articles the person has written. In this case, 3 articles. And in the last example, she's read that article twice. In this case, how many times someone has done something. In this case, the person has read the article twice. We can use the present perfect progressive to talk about how long something has been happening. Okay. In this example, he's been learning English for 6 months. Okay. So, este es un caso en el que usamos el presente perfecto progresivo para indicar cuánto tiempo algo ha venido sucediendo. En este caso, la acción de aprender inglés por 6 meses. Okay. In this case, the person has been learning for 6 months. Okay, you can see the structure of the present perfect progressive. I use In this case, the past participle of been plus the verb learn with ing. Another aspect, the present perfect progressive often shows that something is unfinished. It started in the past and is still continuing. The emphasis is on the continuation of the action. You can see the example here. I've been reading a book about insects. What is the meaning of this sentence? The person started to read a book. The action is still ongoing. It means that the action continues. And the action hasn't finished because the person hasn't finished the book yet. So si digo, he estado leyendo un libro acerca de insectos, significa que la acción aún está en progreso y que la acción aún no se ha terminado, ¿no? Aún no, la persona aún, en este ejemplo, la persona aún no ha terminado de leer el libro. Aún lo está leyendo. The present perfect often shows that something is finished. The emphasis is on the result of the action. If you say, I've read a book about insects, it means that the action is finished. The person has finished the, reading the book about insects. Si digo, he leído un libro acerca de insectos, en este caso el énfasis está en que la persona ha terminado de leer el libro, ¿no? Porque si he leído, ¿no? Indica esta oración que la persona ya ha terminado de leer el libro. We often use the present perfect progressive to show that something is temporary. In this example, they've been living here since 1995, but they're moving next month. In this case, the emphasis is that the action is temporary. ¿No? La acción es temporal. Ellos han estado viviendo aquí desde 1995, pero se van a mudar el próximo mes. Entonces, aquí utilizamos el presente perfecto progresivo para indicar que la acción es temporal. We can use the present perfect to show that something is permanent. This is the contrary. ¿No? They've lived here since they were children. They've always lived here. So in this case, we emphasized, with the present perfect, we emphasize on the action that is permanent. Sometimes you can use either the present perfect progressive or the present perfect. This is especially true with verbs such as live, study, teach, and work with for or since. Como ustedes pueden ver, en algunos casos se pueden utilizar cualquiera de los dos. Cualquiera de los dos que se utilice tiene el mismo significado. If I say, he's been working at UTPL for 6 years, it means the same as if I say he's worked at UTPL for 6 years. In this case, these two sentences have the same meaning. So I can use either the present perfect progressive or the present perfect. So this is all I have to say about this subject. Thank you.